So what does it cost to process residentially collected single-stream recyclable materials? You need to account for the purchase of land, a building to house the recycling processing equipment, the recycling processing equipment itself, the labor used to run the equipment and for sorting of the material and for moving the material from one place to another, the maintenance costs associated with the land, the building, and the equipment, overhead, and any return on investment that would be needed for the business. With the advent of single stream, as was mentioned previously, there is more contamination that is being delivered to the processing facility. This contamination does two things. It slows down the processing system, making it more expensive per ton to process the material. And then there's the added cost for removal and disposal of the non-recyclable materials. The first portion of processing costs has to do with the capital costs required to build a facility. To operate a 500 ton per day facility, you may need 100,000 square feet of building space and an investment of $32 million for the land, building, and equipment. If you do run 500 tons per day times 260 days a year, that would create 130,000 tons per year to be processed. The 260 days is based on 5 days a week, 52 weeks a year. Spreading the capital cost over 20 years and assuming a 10% cost of money or return on investment, this would be the equivalent of having to pay $3.76 million per year for the capital costs associated with the facility. To recover the capital cost over that 20 years, you would take $3.76 million per year divided by 130,000 tons per year that is processed, and that equates to a cost of $28.91 per ton associated with the capital cost of your recycling processing facility. Once you've built the facility, you then have operations and maintenance personnel to run it and maintain it. For a facility of this size at 500 tons per day, you would likely operate the plant at least 20 hours per day, 5 days a week. This would require two 10-hour shifts, one day shift and one night shift. In other words, you would run this plant like a factory around the clock for the most part, using about 4 hours per day on average of downtime for maintenance. If you have an average of 50 persons per shift, that's 100 persons per day, and an average wage of $15 an hour. The average wage is really a combination of higher wage workers and lower wage workers required to operate and maintain the facility, where a sorter would be the least cost, a forklift operator would have a higher cost, and a maintenance worker yet a higher cost for their skills. So if each person works 10 hours per day, 5 days a week, you'd have eight hours of straight time per day plus 2 hours of overtime per day, paid a time and a half. So your personal cost over the year is 100 persons per day at 8 hours at $15 an hour plus 2 hours at time and a half of $15 per hour times 260 days per year, and in this case equates to $4.3 million per year. To calculate the cost per ton, you would divide $4.3 million per year by 130,000 tons processed per year for an operations and maintenance cost of $33.07 per ton. You also need to account for equipment replacement parts, not counting the maintenance labor. It may be reasonable to use that the equipment replacement parts are going to be 10% of operations cost although you would have to look at each particular situation. If replacement parts are 10% of operations cost, this would equate to 10% of $33.07 a ton, or $3.31 a ton. Finally, you have to determine the overhead as a percent of your overall production cost. And typically, for a manufacturing environment, this can vary anywhere between 15 to 25%, depending on the size and type of facility. The overhead includes things like taxes, permitting, insurance, training, employee benefits, and then other overheads such as management personnel for sales, advertising, marketing, data processing, reporting, record keeping, safety, accounting, your general offices, operations and maintenance supervision, quality control, etc. And of course, you also have to account for whatever profit that the facility would require for anyone to make a business investment. Using 15% as the overhead for this example, you would take 15% times the operations cost of $33.07, and that would equate to $4.96 per ton. When it's all said and done, the net value of residentially collected single-stream recyclable materials delivered to a recycling processing facility is the weighted market value of all commodities recovered at the processing facility and sold to end markets, less the processing cost. Assuming an average value of $73.78 a ton for the market value of the recyclable materials, and then subtracting the processing cost of the sum of the capital recovery cost of $28.91 a ton, plus the operations and maintenance personnel cost of $33.07 a ton, plus the parts replacement cost of $3.31 a ton, plus $4.96 a ton for the overhead and profit. This equates to the difference of the market value of $73.78 a ton, less the total processing cost of $70.25 a ton, for a net delivered value of $3.53 a ton. In other words, this is the price paid to a hauling company or municipality delivering single-stream recyclable materials to a processing facility, and does not include the costs associated with the collection of the materials. Some municipalities and some joint solid waste management agencies will often contract for the sale of the recyclable materials tied to published index pricing with a floor price, because the floor price is intended to prevent the municipality or the solid waste action agency from ever having to pay for the recycling processing when the commodity markets are lower. However, in this case, they give up the opportunity to receive higher prices when the markets are higher. Values paid to hauling companies and municipalities have recently been in the range of $0 to $5 a ton, recently being in the years 2013 and 2014. So what are suggestions to improve the process? Again, as we go to single-stream recycling, and as people use lidded carts for automated collection of single-stream recycling, we need an increased emphasis on education to the consumer, to prevent non-recyclable materials going into the recycling cart. Because the more contamination that's put into the recycling cart, the more cost it is to process the material and the less revenue that's obtained from the recyclable material. Sometimes discussions evolve regarding mixed waste processing. In other words, can we simply have one common trash cart where that material can be sent to a processing facility and the recyclable materials pull out of the trash? It turns out that that's very problematic because of the health risk of people exposed to putrescent and hazardous waste that's mixed in with the recyclable materials, and also the rancid and odoriferous materials that are in trash can contaminate recyclable materials. So it's very difficult, at least at this time, to mix trash with recyclables. That's why there are two separate collections for each. With regard to the future market value of recyclable materials cannot be precisely determined. It's always going to be based on current market conditions. Just like trying to predict the stock market or other commodities into the future, there is always uncertainty. However, it is more likely that the net cost for solid waste management will overall continue to be less if recycling is included.